There's a lot of cleaning, as you can see. It's a mess.
But it is a big first step. Another shrimp boat is back where it belongs in the Matanzas Pass off Fort Myers Beach. Hurricane Ian's storm surge pushed the Renee Lynn and dozens of other massive shrimp boats into a mangled mess on land. Thanks for counting on NBC 2 News Tonight. I'm Kyla Gaylor.
And I'm Peter Bush. These boats have been stuck in a pile for nearly 4 months. NBC 2's Gage Golding is on San Carlos Island talking to the Renee Lynn's owners, hoping to be back fishing in just a couple of weeks.
The Renee Lynn is floating again, but it's not exactly smooth sailing from here. Just getting to the boat is a task within itself. The docks are gone and you quite literally have to walk the plank. Once aboard, there's enough cleaning that could keep you busy for weeks.
It's a mess, ain't it?
Rick's boat isn't pretty right now, but it's a lot prettier here than on dry land.
It's a lot of work for them to put you in.
So far, more than 10 shrimp boats have already been put back into the water. On Saturday, it was Rick's turn. As the Renee Lynn rolled into the water, it looked like it was nearly going to capsize.
Just kept going back and forth, and then it started going towards the barge.
It took 4 days to move the just several hundred feet and months to get to that point. During the downtime, Rick repaired holes in the boat's hull and other damage from Ian.
Now that's how you get to my boat.
This?
That's it right there, yep.
To get here, he has to pass through what was the Trico Shrimp Company.
Okay, now hold your breath.
Which, by the way, still has thousands of pounds of shrimp still sealed up in a freezer that hasn't been frozen in months.
That freezer was pretty much full.
Christine Gala is part owner of Trico Shrimp and 12 boats that were beached by Ian. So far, three are back in the water and a fourth is in progress. But like that freezer, the Miss Amy J is also loaded up with shrimp that's been sitting since September.
They came in like the night before the storm, didn't have time to unload.
It's a mess they need to clean up, but it's just part of the mess she's juggling. She's trying to find answers to whether these boats will ever fish again, or can Trico even make a comeback?
We're at the point right now everybody is trying to figure that out.
While the Renee Lynn is back on the water, it'll be about 10 days until she's ready to set out on her first shrimping trip since Ian. But still, it's a small win in the road to recovery. As for the rest of these boats, they'll get back on the water. Just when? Well, that's the million-dollar question.
It's going to take a good long while. Eventually, we'll get there.
Reporting local tonight on San Carlos Island, Gage Golding, NBC2.